Welcome everyone, and thank you for joining us today. Good morning for some of you, good afternoon for the others. Thank you again for joining us today. So the meeting today will talk about the error-proofing system, and we are going to announce the launch of our new DC tools, current control, transducerised cordy tools, as well as battery tools over the next 2 days. My name is Adrien Auger, and I'm the technical sales manager, part of the international team at Mountz. Some of you know me already. For the others, it's a pleasure to meet you and to introduce myself to you today. So again, the aim of this session this morning is to talk about what is an error-proofing screwdriver system. This is a subject that we will discuss about for the next few sessions, so today and tomorrow. Over those sessions, we will introduce the EC and ECT driver systems, which are current control and transducerised tools, again, as well as the battery tools, which is scheduled for tomorrow. But let's start first with a bit of history. The screw was invented roughly 2 to 2.5 years ago. And since that time, the main issue has always been to torque and tighten the screw at the right torque amount. You don't tighten the screw tight enough, the screw is going to get loose and the products will deassemble. If you torque the screw too much, too tight, the screw will be damaged, too much tension in the screw, parts will be damaged, and in the end, the assembly will not hold as well. Which is why applying the right torque amount in the assembly is crucial for a proper fastening and for the parts to stay assembled through time. Years ago, technology developed and we were able to have screwdrivers, air screwdrivers, electric screwdrivers, which will stop at the target torque, giving some quality approach to the assembly, making sure that the torque is reached, the tool stops. Of course, nowadays, the industry has developed a lot and the demands of the customers and users developed as well to have more and more a quality approach to the assembly, making sure that, again, everything is correct at the end of the line. Which brings us to the subject today. Applying the target torque is great, but there are other factors, of course, that are to be taken into consideration during the assembly. So first is to make sure that the torque is actually reached and the proper torque value was applied in the assembly. This is where the TCAM strategy can come in. TCAM stands for torque control angle monitoring, as most of you know. And this strategy is as follows. We have a target torque, let's say 5 Newton meters. We can set a tolerance, plus or minus 10% as an example. So the torque needs to be reached between 4.5 and 5.5 Newton meters. If the torque achieved is not within this tolerance, the assembly will be declared not good and we will have an error. The other part of the TCAM strategy is as well the angle. This is where the angle monitoring comes into play. Reaching the target torque is great, but we need to make sure that the torque is right reached at the right place in the assembly. If the torque is reached too early, this can be meaning that there was a cross thread, so the screw is not properly fully engaged in the assembly, or if the angle, maximum angle is reached, the screw turned for too many turns, there is an issue in the assembly, and this will not be a correct fastening as well. So this is what you see on the graph here on the left side. The TCAM strategy will basically mean that the torque is reached within the right torque tolerance, but also within the proper angle window. With these factors, it is sure that the screw has been properly fastened and that the production can move on to the next one, and so on and so on. The other strategy that is used in the industry is the ACTM strategy. So in that case, instead of having a target torque, we have a target angle and a torque window. This is very similar to the TCAM strategy, just the other way around. It is less common in the industry, but it's still used and it's still important to keep that in mind. So these strategies bring us to the tools that we are launching today. The EC and ECT series include these strategies and will make sure that each screw is properly fastened. The EC series is a current control tool, and the ECT series is a transducerised type of tool. The main difference between both of them is going to be internally to the tool. The EC series is a current control tool where the torque is determined depending on the current consumed by the tool through different algorithms, complicated mathematics. And the ECT series basically includes an inline dynamic sensor constantly reading the torque applied in real time on the assembly. Transducerized type of tool are what you can have as best in the industry in the assembly tools. And this is the tools that we are again launching today. The EC and ECT series come with inline tool, as you can see on the screen here. We also have pistol grip tool, angle head tools, as well as automation tools. The tools work with a controller, you can see as well. And this controller is going to have a touchscreen, different communication ports, and this is something that we will talk a bit more in the few minutes. Tomorrow, we will also review the EPT series. Very similar idea, transducerized tools, but cordless, working on battery. You can see here on the screen the angle head type of tool, pistol grip tool, as well as the controller. These tools can work as standalone tool or communicate with the controller, which can manage several tools at once to really bring flexibility, quality, and traceability to the assembly. These three worlds are really at the heart of error-proofing assembly: quality, traceability, and flexibility. And this is what the ECT, EC, and EPT series are going to bring you and your customers for the assembly lines. First, we talked about tightening strategies, so the ACTM, TCAM strategies. The tools include 15 different presets, which are basically 15 different fastening strategies, for which each of them you will be able to set the target torque, the speed, angle, window, torque tolerance. You will be also able to set different parameters around those presets to make sure that the screw is properly fastened according to your desired assembly process. We have job and models which will allow you to combine those strategies and those presets to that, so that the tool will count, navigate between the different presets by itself. But also it's going to communicate with the PLC, it's going to communicate with the network for being fully integrated in your lines. With the PLC, it will be done with 25 or 36 pin input output. For the network, it's going to be done through Modbus, RS232 Ethernet ports, so that you can collect the data in real time to have full traceability of what's happening on the tools. The EC, ECT, and EPT series also include screw counting features that will make sure that, again, each screw is going to be properly fastened at the right time. So over the next few sessions, we are going to review how to set the EC and ECT controllers, making sure that you can set the target torque, the tolerance, angle window. We can navigate with the jobs and the models. We can also review how the barcode reader works to make sure that the tool is, again, fully integrated into the lines. And we'll see how the tools can really answer today's requirements for the most demanding assembly production lines. Again, these tools are open worldwide now, and they will help you and your customers to bring the most advanced type of tools you can find in the industry right now to your market. So this session is just an opening. Next session, we will see how the presets can be done, the different settings on the controller as well. Second session, or early afternoon for the UK and Western Europe session, is going to be on the job, the models, how we can combine those together so that we have process control in place to bring, again, complete satisfaction to the customers. Tomorrow morning, we will see how the software is used. So the EC, ECT, and EPT tools come with a software, a PC software that allow you to program the tool. The software is included with the tool. There is no license to buy for it. So again, it's included with the tool, free of charge. And that's something that you will, if you don't know us already, that's something that you will find out by working with us, is that when you work with those tools, there is no hidden cost. Everything is included upfront, and you know what you buy and use directly. And the last session tomorrow will be about the battery tools. We will review how the tools can work as standalone tools, how they communicate with the controller, and how we can program those tools to work in a smart way together, bring traceability to the customers, and make sure again that they answer the most demanding assembly lines right now. At this stage, I will ask you if there is already any questions on this short session, this opening session, feel free to ask those questions and write them down in the chat. Tom will read them out loud so we can answer those right away. If you are watching this session on demand, feel free to shoot me an email. You have my email address on the screen now. Write me an email and we will answer your question immediately. Tom? Do we have any questions, Tom? Well, if we don't have questions, thank you again for joining this session this morning. Our next session is going to be at 10:30 UK time, so 1 hour and 15 minutes away. And we will review the basic settings of the EC and ECT series, which are again the coded tools, so that we have a first approach of them and deeper throughout the day, we will go deeper and deeper on the programming, making sure that all your questions are answered by the end of those sessions. Thank you very much, everyone, and see you in 1 hour and 15 minutes.